Howdy, 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 my beautiful Taurus. How are you doing, darling? My name is SimplyVelca, and today we're going to be getting into your weekly tarot reading, Taurus, for July. So if you enjoy this tarot reading here today, Taurus, I'll let you in on a secret. Up right hand corner here, darling, click on that, and you'll be taken to the monthly tarot reading for your Zodiac sign as well. Now, Taurus, if you enjoy my tarot readings, let me know in the comments below, darling. That's how I keep up with you, is hearing in the comments how my tarot readings help you out. Or just let me know if you enjoy the vibes for today, darling, all right, Taurus? Be sure as well, if you want a completely free way to support me, darling, an easy way to do that is give this video a like and subscribe. It helps me out more than you ever possibly could know, and I always appreciate the individuals who take the extra step to do that for me. All right, Taurus, so we're gonna be getting into three rows for you today, all right, for your weekly reading. Remember to consume more than just your one zodiac sign, Taurus. Check out your sun, moon, rising, as well as your Venus. But let's get into this here. Your first row today, Taurus, we're gonna be covering over in regards to your career and financial situation. Your second row, Taurus, we're going to be tapping into your social life. We could be tapping into a romantic situation, platonic, darling, someone in the family, you know, just your social life, Taurus. And then in the third and final row, which is my personal favorite, Taurus, all right, we have coming in here your general tarot predictions and what you need to be hearing at this time, all right? But starting this energy off, darling, we have the Three of Pentacles for you, Taurus, all right? Three of Pentacles, people are going to be approaching you this week, Taurus. You're going to be noticing people wanting to just spend more time with you. You might be getting invited to do some type of extracurricular activity that you normally wouldn't to do, Taurus. I want you to go ahead and do those type of activities. You know, maybe you're going to be approached by a friend and be like, hey, I know you're not really a clubber, Taurus. I know you really like to keep to yourself, darling, but we should just go out sometime. You know, let's enjoy ourselves here. There's something important that's going to be happening associated with you going out. All right. It's like either something inspires you for your future. All right. You might be running into somebody from going out, but it's through the activity of going out, Taurus, and doing things with people, engaging with people that you normally wouldn't engage with, that's the key to get things continuously going forward for you in your life. All right, Taurus, so now let's continue on with this reading here with your social, your career now. You have the Queen of Wands, the Nine of Pentacles, as well as the Ten of Cups coming in here for you, Taurus. All right, keep in mind as well, darling, that we're going to be using the Three of Pentacles influence throughout your entire reading here. What I see coming in for you, Taurus, is the opportunity for you to do something a little bit more passion oriented for yourself, starting a project of your own here. All right, this row really encompasses fulfillment through following with a passion, Taurus. Some of you guys might have been sitting on some type of idea or been really just sitting and waiting for an opportune moment, Taurus, to really take a leap of faith or something, kind of exuding like a full energy. All right, I get like a message for some of you Tauruses here. It's where for a while now you were kind of doubting yourself and your capabilities of being able to accomplish certain things, all right, to being able to get like that dream job or being able to, for some of you guys, right, with this Nine of Pentacles here, developing a stream of revenue, all right, having an increase of financial gain here. And I feel like what happens here, how to continuously have this be manifesting for you, Taurus, it comes in through this sense of being more of that Queen of Wands, being more daring, all right? And it talks more about it's time for you to lead with your heart more, Taurus, rather than leading with the logistics, all right? Because this is all about passion. Don't worry about how something, like logistically, this might seem like it doesn't make sense, right? You know, let's just use tarot, for example. Logistically, it doesn't make sense to be a tarot reader, right? It's, you know, it's not going to pay the bills, seemingly, right? You're just flipping some tarot cards here. Nine of Pentacles energy, that's a very powerful energy for those that are trying to be self-employed, Taurus, all right? So it truly just reads as this dynamic where it's this, instead of leading with your brain, lead with your heart, and that's where the rewards come from, all right? Instead of leading with your brain, lead with your heart. Now, in terms of your social now, your social spread here today, Taurus, you have the Strength card, Hanged Man with the Five of Pentacles here. Taurus, I want to just hug you at this time, darling. I feel as if when it comes to the people that you're surrounding yourself with currently, or those that just end up being around you, there's this sense for you that like it doesn't make you feel good. And it makes me question for you, Taurus. It's like, do you not have a support system? Do you not have people that will defend you? Do you feel as, do you wonder, Taurus, if you were to disappear tomorrow, like who would even notice if it wasn't something that you were providing? Right, Taurus? I get like this sense, it's just like socially, people are just not, like there's this sense of feeling like an outsider, feeling as if you're like the third wheel in every friendship, in every situation here. It's always this sense for you, Taurus, where it's like, you know, for you, it's just like, why are you surrounding yourself with people that wouldn't even bat an eye if you were to just disappear? I feel like for you, Taurus, is here in your social life, the biggest lesson that's going to be happening here is this hanged man, because this is the heart of your energy, Taurus, right? Of your spread here. The hanged man is like a 180 here. Some of you, Tauruses, are feeling called to calling out someone in your personal life, whether this be a family member or a friend, with calling them out on a behavior that just doesn't make you feel good, whether it's through how they talk to you, through what they don't say to you, Taurus, here. I feel like you're getting to this point now for yourself, Taurus, like if you, the continuing on with certain relationships in your life that are just not sustaining you any, and in reality just has you constantly in this place of feeling like you're not enough. The people that you talk to, they make you feel as if you're boring or as if you're always doing something wrong here, Taurus. It's a bummer of an energy here, darling, all right? But this is like a push for you, Taurus, where it's like you're not the crazy one. For some of you, Tauruses, I feel like you're just so used to internalizing everything and be like, okay, I have this issue I need to work on and that issue. So you're used to taking on all the burdens yourself rather than getting comfortable or challenging your... Because I feel like it's for you, it's uncomfortable for you to call out and speak your truth and acknowledge someone else doing something wrong, right? Because you don't want to come off as mean or anything, but I feel like it's really important for you, Taurus, to say your truth, call someone out that isn't respecting you in that way, all right? You're not the crazy one. You're not being too much or emotional or what have you, Taurus. It's like you're a human. You deserve the grace of being human, just like you give the grace to everybody else, Taurus. Now, for your predictions, you have the Ten of Pentacles, the Temperance energy, with the Four of Wands for you, Taurus, all right? You guys are going to be having a really solid home life here, all right? For many of you guys, Taurus, you're holding your back your truth because you don't know if certain people are able to handle your truth here. But they're going to be able to handle it, all right? The only thing that's going to happen, you might have, you know, you get comfortable with the idea of confronting people about what's making you uncomfortable, Taurus, because the people that are meant to be in your close circle, right? These two cards really encapsulate the people that are going to ride for you, Taurus, the people that truly care for you, the people that you're going to consider your loved ones, your true loved ones, your family, even if they're blood or not blood, Taurus, they're going to listen to you. They're wanting to work things through with you. But the thing about it is they have to be clued in on like what makes you feel as if you are a Five of Pentacles. All right. You have to identify that. For some of you as well, Taurus, I get this sense that I just feel as if you need to be reminded, Taurus, of just like how good you are just in general. Maybe this is just because I'm sensing that, you know, some of you guys just might be feeling a little bit down in the dumps here, but I just want to celebrate you and your accomplishments and what you do for the world. All right. Maybe it's through the sense of never being a feeling as if you're being appreciated by the efforts that you do that you wonder. It's like, that's what this is, Taurus. It's like, this makes me think of like a dynamic of where it's just like, let's take the cliche house, the housewife, the wife that stays at the house and the husband that goes to work, right? It's always like that cliche that some men usually try to project, being like, oh, if you're a housewife, you're doing nothing, right? When in reality, it's like the housewife keeps the house in order, takes care of the kids, makes sure there's a hot meal and what have you, right? It's a full job in of itself, but they never get the credit. And so sometimes some people, whether you're a housewife or a house husband, honey, how you doing, right? Those people will sometimes feel as if they're just a burden or a nuisance because no one is saying thank you for doing the things that they're doing. No one is saying thank you, Taurus, for the things that you are doing. And so the only way that you're going to feel empowered is by saying, just like, hey, I want to be told thank you. I want to be acknowledged for how I keep this roof over our heads, how I keep this family together here, Taurus, right? That's like the message here, is where it's just like, you need to be the one to boast about what it is that you do, because if you don't, other people are going to make you feel as if you don't do anything. And while it's unfortunate, Taurus, that it should be going without saying, darling, some people are just dense, right? As we all have experienced, I'm sure. So that's what, you know, take the message and how it resonates, Taurus. But let's just start clarifying your tarot cards now. All right, we're going to start clarifying your career and financial situation firstly. As a reminder, it was the Ten of Cups, Nine of Pentacles with that Queen of Wands, okay? Back of the deck is this Judgment energy for you, Taurus. All right, Spirit is letting you know that they're going to be taking a very active role when it comes to your financial life here, Taurus, in the coming days. So be anticipating a lot of changes. It's almost as if Spirit is having to intervene in when it comes to the work that you are doing, because it's like the work that you're doing is not paying out in what it is that you're deserving of. So Spirit is going to be like identifies this, and they're just like, wait a minute, Taurus. Like, Taurus needs to get a little bit more from this. So it's like, you know, think about it where it's just like HR is getting involved with the situation, I feel. And so you'll start noticing that some people might subscribe to it as like some type of karmic experience starting to happen in your career. I'm being shown the Wheel of Fortune as well. Now, the clarifier is here. Knight of Swords, Hierophant energy with the Lover's card as well. For you, Taurus, what's going to be happening here? I feel like your spiritual team is going to be manifesting something that you can really put your root into. If you are having anxiety when it comes to self-employment, Taurus, or having anxiety about some job that seems that feel, it's like you're going to be getting opportunities that feel as if they're not, that they're temporary or fleeting. Maybe you'll get the opportunity to be able to make some good money from a side gig or something like that, but you're worried about it being fleeting. Don't worry about that at all. I also feel like for you, Tauruses, networking seems to be very valid for you at this point in time. It's like how you get the job that you want, how you start creating the life, creating the career that you want for yourself. It's not necessarily the talents or the that is lacking. It's who you know, and it's through who you know that can get you to the right connections, right? You say you want to be an author, Taurus, perhaps, as an analogy. You know, it's through your networking, that's how you end up meeting the publisher, right? To help you get through the door. Okay, and that's why you don't want to be thinking about your career and from such a logistical standpoint, because logistically it doesn't make sense for you to be able to launch a book, but it makes sense if you follow with a passion, get to the right resources, connect with the right people, Taurus, that then makes that idea of where you creating like a book seems completely out of the blue, like unrealistic. It's through the people that you know, makes that job, makes that situation a lot more realistic. All right, so I hope that makes sense for you, Taurus. Clarifying your social life now with that Strength card, Hanged Man, as well as Five of Pentacles here. We have the Eight of Cups, Queen of Pentacles here with the King of Swords. Back of the deck is the Four of Swords energy here. All right, Taurus, again, there is this sense for you where it's like you need to speak your truth about a situation. You might have some distance initially, right? It's like the sense of where you need to speak your side about something. Might be some disagreements, might be having to, you know, sleep on the couch for a couple of nights there. Taurus might not have some text messages from a while from them for you know, just for a hot biscuit, but the healing happens. The thinking happens through the silence. All right, and so that's what I want to remind you of, Taurus, is that yes, the confrontation might be uncomfortable initially, but what happens after is beautiful. All right, so you don't have to be in this state forever, Taurus. Your clarification cards here are the Eight of Cups, King of Swords, Queen of Pentacles. You know, the Queen of Pentacles is not afraid of speaking up. The King of Swords isn't afraid of speaking up either, because the King of Swords has the confidence in knowing how they are perceiving the situation is completely rational, and how they approach the situation is from a rational, mature standpoint. What the King of Swords is speaking the truth about is the Queen of Pentacles, which is that sense of where you are not being sustained from some type of connection here. You need more from a situation, because at this current point in time, I see you starting to emotionally disconnect from a situation. Because it's like you're so used to having to ride on your own, you're being, you know, having to be left on your to your own devices, never having help from these people. You're being shown, you're being taught how to live without them. That's what this is. It's like you're being taught to how to live without them. So if they don't start trying to make a place for themselves in your life, having an impact, positive impact on your life, Taurus, you're going to walk away. But I get the sense for you, many of you Tauruses, it's like the anxiety is the scariest part. What will actually happen in reality is a lot better of an outcome than what I think a lot of you Tauruses are thinking. Okay. Clarifying your third row, Taurus, we have back of the deck energy. Remembering your third row is the 10 of Pentacles, 4 of Wands, and Temperance energy. Also, I'm noticing two 10s here. By the way, 10s representing closures to cycle. So it's almost like the ending of a phase and dynamic of like what behavior you'll allow. Anyways, Page of Pentacles in the back of the deck here. Be expecting communication from somebody. All right, Taurus, be expecting communication from somebody that you went silent from for a little bit, or they went silent on you. All right, it's going to provide some closure. There's nothing you can do about the situation currently. All right, so don't push it. When people go silent, wait for them to reach back out, because they absolutely will. Taurus, all right, for some of you guys, I get like this message where you need to go back to your own home base for a little bit, away from an environment, so you can be left to your own devices as well, so you can remember, you know, get some of your personality back. It's almost like for some of you Tauruses, it's like you've had to suppress so much of your own being, so much of your own personality, because of the environment that you're in, that you don't feel comfortable being yourself, Taurus. So I see definitely for some of you guys, you know, to break free from these restrictions that you've been currently dealing with, it requires for you to get out of a situation. For overall though, Taurus, what I want to be saying is, like, again, like who and what it is that you've invested into at this time, Taurus, that's not the problem. It just requires fine-tuning, all right, darling? That's really what this is fine-tuning. A lot of people get really lost, Taurus, on this idea that the human life and everything that we're experiencing needs to be just utmost perfect the moment we are connecting with it, or otherwise it's not going to happen, it's not going to work out. When the reality is, Taurus, we are all human, which basically means we are all imperfect. And so what happens as a humans, we're social creatures, when we connect with one another, you have to figure out how to make our imperfectness, our quirks, work well together. It's not always going to be just a well-oiled machine, but it requires for both parties, or if there's more, to be willing to put in the work, to be willing to acknowledge that their perspective and your perspective isn't important, or it is important, but no one's in the more right than the other person, is willing to work together on this, no longer having an individualistic type of point of view, which I don't think you suffer from, Taurus. I feel like it's the other party. So I love you so much, Taurus. This is the weekly tarot reading that I have for you, darling. Remember to check out top right hand corner right here, darling, all right, to get your monthly tarot reading. And if you want to book a private reading with me, my website's linked down below, Taurus, SimplyVelca.com. Next to my social medias, if you want to connect with me on a more intimate level, are TikTok and Instagram, Taurus, both which are just Simply Velca. Until next time though, Taurus, I love you so much, darling, and hopefully I can connect with you sometime in the near future. Bye, darling Taurus.